Today we are going to discuss the generating function for Gn of x. You know, Gn of x means Bessel function, and how it is defined and how we can prove it, we will see in this lecture. You know, the function e raised to the power x over 2 into t minus 1 over t, this is known as generating function for Gn of x. When you say that e raised to the power x over 2 times t minus 1 over t is generating function for Gn of x, it means what? It means we can express this e x over 2 t minus 1 over t equal to summation n from minus infinity to plus infinity t raised to the power n gn of x. So first of all, we will see the proof of this theorem, and after that we will explain this theorem by taking some important examples in another lecture. Now, to prove it, let us see. You know, e raised to the power x, this is defined as 1 plus x plus x square over 2 factorial plus x cube over 3 factorial and plus so on, you know. And in compact form, we define this e x in this way. This is summation r 0 to infinity x raised to the power r over r factorial. So in the light of this definition of ex, you can define the ex over 2 t minus 1 by t. But how? For this, you can see in that in the light of that equation, we can write e x t over 2. Here at the place of x, there is x t over 2. So from the definition of e to the power x, you may write it in this way: summation r 0 to infinity x to the power r t to the power r over 2 to the power r and r factorial. Let us say this is equation 1. Now in similar manner, we can also define e to the power minus x by 2t. So similarly, you can say e to the power minus xt over 2, minus x over 2t, not xt, x over 2t. This is another factor, and here at the place of x, there is minus x by 2t, and so you can see this will be an alternating series. The sign of the alternate terms will be different. So we define this alternating series in this way. This is summation s 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to the power s x to the power s over 2 raised to the power s t raised to the power s into s factorial. This is, these two expressions have been just written from the definition of this e x. So now we will simply multiply these two equations, that is equation 1 and equation 2. So you can see multiplying 1 and 2, we get after multiplication of these two equations 1 and 2, you can see when we will multiply e raised to the power xt by 2 and e raised to the power minus x by 2t. Our result will be e raised to the power x by 2 into t minus 1 over t. And this will be equal to, see the RHS of equation 1 and equation 2 and multiply them. So you can see this will be simply summation r 0 to infinity x raised to the power r t raised to the power r over 2 raised to the power r times r factorial. And from equation 2, this will be summation s 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to the power s x raised to the power s over 2 raised to the power s t raised to the power s times s factorial. Now from this equation 3, we can easily find the coefficient of the nth term, or you can say t nth term. So for this, we will simply replace in this equation 3 r by n plus s. Then you will be able to find the coefficient of t to the power n. So you can say, in order to find t nth term, we replace r by n plus s. That is, you can say we will take r equal to n plus s, r equal to n plus s. Then you can see when we will replace r by n plus s, then the coefficient of t to the power n is, what will be the coefficient? You can easily see. In fact, that coefficient will be equal to summation s 0 to infinity. See here, r has been replaced by n plus s. So here, x to the power r is present, and we will replace r by n plus s. So there will be x to the power n plus s over, in denominator there is 2 raised to the power r, r will be replaced by n plus s. So this will be 2 raised to the power n plus s. And there is factorial r, and that will be n plus s factorial. Simply, r has been replaced by n plus s. And the second factor you may write at is, so this is minus 1 raised to the power s, x raised to the power s, and over 2 to the power s, and s factorial, because we are taking the coefficient of t to the power n. Now, see this expression in RHS of this result, and you can easily see what will be the simplification. Since here is x to the power n plus s, and here you can see there is x to the power s. So this will be simply x to the power n plus 2s. And in denominator, you can see there is 2 raised to the power n plus s, and here is 2 raised to the power s. So when we will multiply it, this will be 2 raised to the power n plus 2s. And so from this result, we can easily write that this coefficient is equal to summation s 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to the power s and 1 over s factorial times n plus s factorial and x over 2 raised to the power n plus 2s. And you know, actually, this is the definition of Jn of x. So, in fact, this is Jn of x. You know, we have already studied the definition of this function, which is Legendre's function, which is Bessel function of first kind, Jn of x. And we have defined already it in the previous lecture, and you have seen this Jn of x is defined in this manner. So we have written instead of this expression Jn of x. Now again, the coefficient of t raised to the power minus n can be obtained by similar manner. And for this, we will actually substitute s equal to n plus r. S equal to n plus r. Then you will get actually the coefficient of t raised to the power minus n. So you can say again, say this is equation 4. Again, the coefficient of t raised to the power minus n is obtained by putting s equal to n plus r, s equal to n plus r, and then the coefficient of t raised to the power minus n will be what? You can see, in fact, in this condition, the first factor in this equation 3 will remain same, and here t will contain actually a minus n power, and so you can write simply x raised to the power r over 2 raised to the power r times r factorial, and in second factor we will simply replace s by n plus r, and then we will select actually the coefficient of t raised to the power minus n. So you can see what will be that. That will be simply r from 0 to infinity x raised to the power r over 2 raised to the power r times r factorial into minus 1 raised to the power n plus r, because here there is s and s has been replaced by n plus r, and times x to the power s, and s will be written now n plus r, and over 2 raised to the power n plus r times n plus r factorial. And you can see from here, we can write this result in this way. Since there will be here minus 1 raised to the power n times minus 1 raised to the power r, and you know n has no relation with this summation, because we are taking the summation with respect to r. So we will take this minus 1 raised to the power n outside of the summation. So I am writing it in this way, minus 1 raised to the power n summation r 0 to infinity, And now combine the other terms. Here x raised to the power r, and here is x raised to the power n plus r. So when you will multiply it, you will get x raised to the power n plus 2r. And in denominator, you can see there is 2 raised to the power r, and here 2 raised to the power n plus r. So when you will multiply this 2 raised to the power r and this, then you will get 2 to the power n plus 2r. And so we can write this. This is minus 1 raised to the power r, raised to the power r, and divided by r factorial. You can see here is r factorial, and then n plus r factorial, and x over 2 raised to the power n plus 2r. N plus 2r. And again, you can see the expression inside this summation is nothing. This is simply jn of x. So we can write that this coefficient is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n times jn of x. And say this is equation 5. First of all, you can also see in the previous lecture we have seen that this minus 1 raised to the power n times jn of x, this is simply j minus n of x. We have already seen this in previous lecture. So say this is equation 5. So what we are seeing on the basis of equation 4 and equation 5, you can see that when actually we will take the function e to the power x over 2 into t minus 1 by t, then that can be expressed simply by the summation of t to the power n times of jn of x. So you can say, so from equation 4 and 5, you can see 4 and 5, we have what we will get: e to raised to the power x over 2 times t minus 1 over t, and this will be equal to summation n from minus infinity to plus infinity t raised to the power n jn of x. And actually this is the result which was to prove. So you can see in this way that this function e raised to the power x over 2 times t minus 1 by t can be expressed as a coefficient of t to the power n as a coefficient of, yes, t to the power n, and that will be actually jn of x. So this is the generating function for jn of x. So in this lecture we have seen only the proof of this theorem, and after this in another lecture we will see some of its important applications. In fact, this generating function is very important for solving the problem for various competitive examinations like NET, CSIR and JRF. So you should take it seriously and solve so many problems from your textbook.